Hi fam, Random Chick here, and today we are going to be doing some more Southern slang, so yeah. So here's the first one. Aren't you just precious? And I'm going to tell you what these Southern slangs mean, okay? Most people would take aren't you just precious as a compliment, but no, it's not a compliment. It is something that we say if somebody else is being offensive towards us. So it's basically we're being sarcastic. Aren't you just precious? That girl's just being fucking ugly. Being ugly, okay? It don't have anything to do with your physical appearance. It's pretty much you're just misbehaving. I know that bitch ain't talking to me. She's barking up the wrong tree. So barking up the tree, that's pretty much a means that they're mistaking you or misguided. Bless your heart or bless her heart. So bless your heart pretty much means it's someone that we find dumb or stupid and, you know, or yeah, that they're misguided in some kind of way. And we're like, oh, man, I feel so sorry for them. Bless their heart. Here's one of my favorites. Breeches. Breeches is pants or trousers or whatever. We call them breeches. Some of us call them breeches. But anyways, they're pants that you pretty much wear. So, yeah. I gotta, like, use it in a sentence like, girl, I bought me some new britches today, and they was the shit. Here's another funny one, catty cornered. Okay, when we say catty corner, we mean something diagonal. So, like, buildings on a street is catty cornered. Okay, so Coke. When we say, oh, we want a Coke, we're not necessarily saying that we want a Coca-Cola. Okay, most people define it as we want a Coca-Cola, but we're not necessarily saying that we want a Coca-Cola. We're saying we want a Coke, meaning any kind of Coke. Like, most people call it soda, most people call it pop. We just call all drinks Coke. That boy right there don't have a pot to piss in. Okay, don't have a pot to piss in. That means you are extremely broke. You ain't got no money, no ride, no nothing. You don't have a pot to piss in. Another thing that we say, and oh my God, I say this all the time, and I know everybody else says it, but you're like, I'm fixing to, or fixing to. In a minute, I'm fixing to. Fixing to means you're about to do something. Yeah, or you're thinking about doing something. You're fixing to. Another one that we use is, I'm about to fly off the handle. Fly off the handle means you're about to lose it. You're about to snap on somebody. So get the hell out of the way. I'm about to fly off the fucking handle up in here. Another one that a lot of people use that I know is, I can't believe he fucked me over. He gave me the short end of the stick. So the short end of the stick means that it was an unfair deal that went wrong, or somebody messed you over and you got the short end of the stick. Okay, another one we call them hissies, hissy fit, hissies, whatever. It's somebody that is grown up that's acting like a toddler. So we're like, that girl, she's just throwing a hissy fit, or she's just a big fucking hissy. Another one we all know is hold your fucking horses. That means be patient. Hold up and hold your horses. Not right now. Another one is holler. Holler at me when you put the kids to bed or something, you know. That means to let somebody know. Holler. Holler at me. Let me know. Or holler at me. Hit me up. Another one we say is mudding. We're about to go mudding. If somebody tells you that you're about to go mudding and you've never been mudding, you don't want to go. Point blank, you do not want to go. Because the object of mudding is pretty much you get in a truck, a four-wheeler, a four-wheel drive, or anything that is a big vehicle. You go through mud, and the goal is to see how much mud you can go through before your vehicle loses control. So that's mudding. Another word that we use is I reckon, meaning to believe something is true, or you know, like somebody asked you, hey, you want to go bowling, or you want to go to the skating ring, or you want to do this, you want to do that, you just respond with I reckon. That means I don't know at the moment, or maybe, or I don't know. So it's not a no, it's not a yes, it's not a maybe, it's a I reckon. Another thing we say is if you can't run with the big dogs, then stay on the porch. That means taking a risk at something that may have consequences that is not good. So yeah, pretty much, if you can't run with the big dogs, keep your ass on the porch. Another one is a snake in the grass. So like, if I was to call a girl, that girl's just a snake in the grass. That means she is a conniving person that will strike at any time with no warning or little warning. We also call dinner supper here. So if you say dinner, we say supper. S-U-P-P-E-R, supper. We also say tore up. That girl's tore up. That means that girl's broken, heartbroken or whatever. So yeah, or I'm gonna tear up your ass. That means you gonna whoop somebody. Another word we say is carry on. So say a kid's having a fit, and you know, they just got home from school and they're pitching a fit, and you're like, well, why don't you just carry on with it? Carry on with it. I don't care. Another one we say is you're too big for your britches. That means that you take yourself too seriously. You're too big for your britches. Or you think that you're better than everybody else. You're just too big for your britches. Another word that we use is upside. Upside. Yeah, like I'm gonna smack your ass upside your head. And that pretty much means the long way of saying up, like smacking somebody upside their head. We call our hometown or where we're from our stomping grounds. Girl, that's my stomping grounds. Nobody knows me there. That's our hometown or where we're from.